Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. This is Fatal. Today we're going to be going over the Logitech G303 and seeing if this is a mouse you guys would like to have. We're going to be going over the specs, you know, the buttons, all that good stuff on it. But first off, let's do a little history lesson here. The actual G303 original was the Daedalus Apex, and it actually had RGB on it. But that's about where the good stuff ends, because the mouse itself, you know, actually the dimensions on these two mice are not similar at all. They are actually two different mice, and I think you guys should know that, just in case you guys are ready to get this mouse for your gaming needs. So the original G303 Daedalus Apex released in 2015, the length was 11.2 millimeters, the grip width was 5.66 millimeters, and the height of it was 3.83 millimeters. So your height obviously is going to be up and down there. Length is self-explanatory, and your width is pretty much the same as well. So, you know, it's going to be from left to right in the middle. That's your width. But that's where it changes. I don't know why they decided to go with a different size of the mouse itself, but they did. The G303 Shroud Edition length is 11.7, the grip is 5.62, and the height is 3.97 millimeters. So those that don't know, it is not just a re-release of the G303 Daedalus Apex released in 2015. Okay, as far as size-wise goes, if you're looking for a palm grip, you will need between 17.5 centimeters and 19.5 centimeters. And if you want to go claw grip, which is going to be, you know, like this, it's going to be 19 centimeters to 21 centimeters. And then if you want to go fingertip, which is up here, you're going to have to go 19 centimeters to around 22 centimeters. That's going to be probably the size hands that you're going to need if you want to use those positions on the mouse. Me personally, the mouse instantly makes me want to go straight to claw whenever I grab this mouse. And that is not how I'm accustomed to running when I'm have my mouse. My MZ1 is almost, it's not a palm, it's more of a fingertip, you know, slash palm hybrid grip. I have 17.78 centimeter hands from the tip of my middle finger to the base of my palm for reference. But because of the way the back of this mouse is angled, at almost to a point, it's really hard to have control of the mouse with the base of my palm. As you can see in here, as I'm doing this, that's my palm right there. So it's kind of hard for me to reach over here and just be doing this all the way with my hands on this mouse. This mouse does not work really well like that. So that's just me. I use more of a claw finger hybrid grip personally. The weight of this mouse comes in at 73.72 grams. Not the lightest of mice for sure, compared to the 63 grams of the G Pro Super Light. But that's about what I'm getting, is the 73.74. So let's go ahead and do some sound flick test on this thing, so you guys can actually see what the mouse sounds like. You know, I'm sure you've probably already seen it somewhere. But anyways, let's get into this. It's going to be mouse 1, mouse 2. Okay, then we're going to go to the side here. It's going to be the back one. And then we got the front. And then we got the click on the scroll wheel. And then the scroll wheel itself. Now personally, the one on the right is a little bit more high pitched, I think, than the one on the left. But other than that, they feel really good in game as I'm gaming with the mouse. Now as far as the skates go on here, as you can see, they're big old giant skates, and it makes it really awesome when it comes to moving them around the mouse pad. Nice and slick. But anyways, the original G303 didn't have rounded edges on the skate, so this is an improvement for the skates on this one, which is zero additive PTFE mouse feet. It's a given or a must with the mice these days. They last longer and have a better glide compared to the old gen skates that were not 100% PTFE skates. And yeah, so that's going to be pretty awesome when it comes to, you know, these skates actually lasting a long time. So the next thing we're going to talk about here is the mouse has a storage compartment on the back of your wireless dongle, for your wireless dongle, which is going to be back here on the back for any of you guys that actually need to travel with this thing and keep your dongle put away. And yes, so the cable is rubber. It's a nice improvement to finally see the Type-C connector for charging on these Logitech mice, because for the longest time they had the other freaking little bitty one on there. It can be used connected while charging. With that being said, the battery life is so good that unless you run the mouse down to zero, you're not going to have an issue with the usual hassles of a bulky wire. The G303 uses the Hero 25K sensor, which is right in line with the Pixar 3389 sensor that a lot of your type mice use these days. It supports an up to 1000 hertz polling rate and up to 25,000 DPI adjustment. I don't think anyone is going to have or use a DPI that high, but it's there if you need it. Price of the G303 Shroud Edition comes in at around $125 plus shipping and tax, depending on from where you purchase the mouse. Compared to the Pro X Lightspeed at $150 and not having Type-C connector, I think it was a great move on Logitech's part to show the community it is listening by changing that connector. In conclusion, me personally, I don't think it is going to be a very safe mouse, but for a few niche players. Unlike the G Pro Wireless that pretty much has a universal grip ability for most gamers. In my opinion, there are better mice on the market that are better for aiming. In other words, unless you have your aim grip down, it's not going to be comfortable for newcomers. Can I recommend this mouse to anyone? Yes. I've enjoyed using it myself, but I am all about having the right size mouse and not having something just because it's the popular choice at the moment. I waited years for the perfect mouse for me, and that mouse ended up being the MZ1. So do your homework and your math. Sure, it's cool to brag about having the best and the greatest, but just remember, Samson defeated a whole army with nothing more than a jaw of a donkey, while the enemy had the best tech of the day. Guys, I appreciate y'all for dropping in. Thanks for watching, and please consider dropping a sub if you like this video, and a thumbs up if you found the video informative. With all that being said, this is Fatal, signing out.